gonna level up, level up, level up. You gonna level up. Good evening, all of you impactors out there. It's lovely to be able to be with you this evening, even though we can't meet at the church, but to be able to meet with you in your homes. So tonight, I hope you were leveling up. I won't try and do the whole dance thing because I'm quite sure I'm not going to get it right. But I trust you've been taking time with your families to level up and just go deeper with God. Because really, that's what it's about, is in our walk with the Lord, we just want to go deeper each day. So I trust you've been spending time with your families, and all you've been learning together and spending is just taking you deeper with God. So tonight we're going to continue with the theme that you've actually started with Impact, where the kingdom of God is like. So tonight we're going to be sharing about the kingdom of God is like a treasure. So we're going to go to our scripture first, Matthew 13:44, and it says, the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure that a man discovered hidden in a field. In his excitement, he hid it again and sold everything he owned to get enough money to buy the field. So I know you all love going on treasure hunts, because I love going on a treasure hunt as well. Any treasure hunt we have, whether it's at home or whether it's somewhere else, going on a treasure hunt is actually a lot of fun. So when you go on a treasure hunt, we know that you actually need a map. You first of all, when you go treasure hunting, you need a map. And then it guides you to where the treasure is, and generally X marks the spot. So now if we think about that scripture verse that we've read tonight, we see that the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure. So our map is the Word of God. That is our map. And that's going to tell us how to find the treasures for the kingdom of God. If we go into our map inside here, we will find that there are very, very many treasures hidden for us. So I'm sure you would have noticed we have a treasure box here. And I'm sure you just want to know what's inside this treasure box, because there must be some exciting things. So I'm going to open our treasure box. Oh, wow. This is amazing, all the treasures. I'm just going to, so grateful that I have the opportunity to share the different treasures in here. So let's just have a look here first of all. It says, the kingdom of heaven treasures. So these treasures that are actually in here are what we find in the map. It's the different treasures that God has given us in His Word and for us to live in our lives. So we're going to dig a bit deeper and find out what are some of the treasures that God has given us. So let's have a look here first. There we go. There's the first one. And let's have a look what this one says. There's actually a scripture verse on it here as well. And this treasure is love. We want to remember how much God loves each and every one of us. So let's look at this verse, John 3, verse 1. See what great love the Father has lavished on us. That's you and that's me as well. That we should be called the children of God. And that is what we are. We are the children of God. When we've accepted Jesus into our lives, we are His children. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know Him. So those that don't know Him don't know how much He loves them and the valuable treasure that they have. So I'm just going to take a little look here. We're going to take our verse off here. And we're just going to have a look at what we have here in this treasure as we cut it out here. Because remember, we've just learned about one of the treasures that God has given us is His love. And how amazing His love is for each one of us. So let's have a look what our treasure is. Treasure is love. God's love for each one of us. I want you just to remember that as you sit in your homes there, that God loves each one of you so very, very much. So we're going to go now to our next treasure, which was our next verse. So I'm going to read you that one, because our next treasure after love is salvation. So we know that John 3:16, you all know that scripture verse very well. I know for many of you impactors that when you've been with us at Impact, we've actually learnt and memorized that scripture. And others of you that have maybe not been to Impact, you also know that scripture really well. So John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life. So we know, we saw the heart, we saw God's love and how much He loves us. And we know that because He loves us, we know that He sent Jesus Christ to die on the cross for each one of us. And we see that He sent His Son because He loves us. God sent His only Son because He loves us.
And that's something, one of the biggest treasures we can experience in God's word is the fact of how much he loves us, because he loved us so much that he sent Jesus to die on the cross for each one of us, for you and for me. But not only did Jesus die, he rose again so that we can have victory in and through him. So remember that. That is the second, one of the second treasures that God has given us, was first love and now salvation. So let's just put that aside and let's have a look at our third treasure. You're going to wonder what this treasure, why this treasure looks like it does. There's my cell phone. Okay, so for many of you, you're going to say, that's not a cell phone. But you know what? This is almost what my first cell phone looked like, except mine was just a little bit smaller, but it looked something like this. And this treasure that we have on here is the privilege and the honor of being able to pray. So it's prayer. And Isaiah 33:3 says, call to me and I will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. So God says we can pray, we can call on him, we can talk to him, just like we're going to talk to our friends and that, while we're not able to visit them, we can talk to God as well. And know that he's there all the time with you. And you can just call on him because he says so in his word. Call on me, he says, and I will answer you. So you have to listen for him as well to know that he actually will answer you. Let's have a look at our next one. This is a very interesting one. This is going to be a bit heavy. There we go. Okay, here I have a jar of water. And this one represents peace in our hearts. Now, I know at this time we sometimes might be feeling a little bit anxious. Some of you might feel anxious that you've had to stay at home, and we know everybody's a little bit scared about the things that are going on. But let's listen and see, because this is a treasure God gives you, the peace in your heart. He says in Peter 5, verse 7, cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. Philippians 4, 7 says, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. So we can give all our problems to Jesus Christ. And he says we don't need to worry, we don't need to fear, we don't need to be anxious, because he's there for us. So I want us to take those today. Let's write down here fear. Let's write down here cares that we have, our cares. And let's write down our worry that we have. And let's take all of this and give it to Jesus and say, please take away all of that for me, because I know that you've promised me in your word that you will take away all my cares, all my worries, and I do not need to be anxious about anything. So let's see this. This is, as I said, a bottle of water, and it represents Jesus, because Jesus is the living water. So let's take our worries, our fears, our troubles, and let's just give them to him so that we can see how he just takes them away and how they all just dissolve. You know, the enemy's going to come and he's going to try and say to you and put negative thoughts in your mind, and he's going to try and make you be worried and anxious. But we know now what it says there, that we do not need to be anxious, but that we can give all our cares and our worries to the Lord, because he will take them away. The last one I have today, and I think it's, oh, no, it's not. There's another one. So we're going to quickly look at the next one. This one, look at my loaf of bread. Isn't that cool? And this is about the fact that God provides for us. It says there in the scripture in Philippians 4, 19, and my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. So while you are sitting in your house and your family are all there and you can't go anywhere and do much, we know that God says he's still going to provide all our needs. Our food, and what about the money we're going to need? God's going to provide our finances as well. The money that we're going to maybe need for some things that we need to buy or pay for, God says he will make a way. He will provide for us. And how about clothes? That's another thing we always need, is clothes. We need to be able to wear clothes. So it's part of the provision that God has for each one of us. Then our last thing that we're going to look at, the treasure. Now remember, all these things that I've shared out of this treasure chest are the treasures that God has for us. There are so many more treasures in his word. We just have to dig deeper. The last one I want to share with you is this one here. Let's take the scripture verse and let's just read this verse. Have a look at that, because this verse says our other treasure is healing. Isaiah 53:5 says, but he was wounded for our transgressions. In other words, Jesus died on the cross for us. He was bruised for our iniquities. He was beaten. He was bruised for our sins. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. And then we know as well in Psalm 91, there are many verses that tell us he won't let plague come near our dwelling. He won't let the pestilence come near us. Thousands will fall around us, but he will keep us strong and he will keep us firm. So we can remember how much he loves us and how much he says that he promises healing to us. So I want you to just now, with your family, think about what treasures you need to take out of God's word. What treasures do you need in your home in this time that you're all at home together? What are the particular treasures? And let's just spend a little bit of time with God now and just tell him what treasures we need from him. What are our needs? Do we need provision? Do we need healing? Do we need our worries to be taken away? And let's just pray together. Lord, we thank you at this time that, Lord, even though we are sitting at home and we're on our own with our families, we thank you for the family time together. But we thank you for the many treasures that you've promised us and you've given to us. And we just ask, God, that you would just take these treasures, Lord, and just make them a reality in our life. May we dig deeper into your word to know what the treasures are. Thank you that you've promised us we do not need to be anxious. We do not need to be worried. That by your stripes we are healed. That you provide for us because you love us so much. And all because you, Jesus, died on the cross and rose again so that we can spend eternity with you. We thank you, Lord, now, and I just pray for each one of the families and the children watching here tonight. And we just ask that you just bless them in such a mighty way. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. So bye, all our impact people and our adults and the children. And we look forward to meeting up with you again. Bye for now. We're gonna level up, level up, level up. You're gonna level up.